See, just because I don't really believe that. I know that it happens, but most of these whirlwind, you know, we've been knowing each other 30 days and we're getting married type situations, they usually don't work out.
I was rooting for them because just of the past relationships with her and her sisters and their inside the past relationships with athletes. Mm-hmm. So I was like, okay, Chloe seems like a more like a person, more intellectual thinker. Like she thinks things through more than maybe her other sisters. Like I just get that impression from her. So I thought that maybe she vetted Lamar Odom more. Not that she didn't, but I just thought that if he would have been in a bad place, that she would have been there to like meet him on that level. Mm. I don't know. But I just thought that I was definitely rooting for them to work out. And I was like, dang, that they didn't. I was shocked.
Yeah. Yeah. I wasn't shocked, but I was rooting for them. And I was disappointed that they didn't make it. But now I'm rooting for Lamar and Sabrina.
Now I'm rooting for Lamar and Sabrina.
Yeah.
There we go. I have a good feeling about this. I didn't have no feeling about the one before. That's what should have told me.
Before we start wrapping it up, we're going to go ahead and get into some TV stuff. So Breaking Bad, the movie, is coming to Netflix in October. October 11th is the air date.
Wow, that was fast.
Yeah, no. Well, it's been, I heard whispers about it in the past, but yeah, so, yeah, yeah. I don't think there's any Walter White in this one. I think it's only Jesse Pinkman.
Hmm, interesting.
Yeah, so.
Is it a pre or a post?
It's like a sequel. It picks off. Okay. It's a movie that takes off, kind of like The Sopranos is a prequel. It's the opposite of Sopranos.
Okay.
Sopranos is a prequel movie. Is before the series, and then Breaking Bad is a sequel movie that takes place after the series. So that's what's going on with that. And I actually have, let's see, let's play this little quick teaser.
I don't know what to tell you. I ain't said like 500 times already. I have no idea where he is. Don't know where he's headed either. North, south, west, east, Mexico, the moon. I don't have a clue. But yo, even if I did, who wouldn't tell you? Because I've been watching the news same as everybody else. I seen that little cage of his they kept him in. I heard about what all they did to him to make sure he kept cooking. So sorry. I don't know what to tell you. No way I'm helping you people put Jesse Pinkman back inside a cage.
El Camino, Breaking Bad, the movie.
Mm, I'm here for that.
Oh, yeah. I'm here for it, too.
I loved Breaking Bad so much with all my heart. I really did.
Yeah, I liked it, too. It was really good.
It was one of those things that really even when it ended, I was like, all right, so then next week, I'm going to be back. Next week, I'm going to still come back and watch this channel because I just don't know what else to do. I was really in love with it.
So I told you guys about the Wu-Tang series that's coming out.
Oh, okay.
It's a limited series. Okay. So it's like a
new edition one.
Something like that, yeah. It's not starring Wu-Tang. It's about Wu-Tang and how they got their start and whatnot. It's on Hulu, and that starts on September 4th, coming up.
Awesome. A few weeks away.
All right. So with that, let's go ahead and get into our question of the week. All right, our question of the week for this week is, what purchase do you regret the most? Okay. All right, okay, so Didi, while I'm going over these, can you look for a question for next week?
Oh, yeah, I know which question I want for next week.
Oh, okay. So here we go. Chris Ritchie says, the Benz, back in the day, total waste. I really like American cars. Easy said buying a 1999 Cadillac Eldorado ETC with a North Star engine. Damn car went 49,000 miles and promptly blew a head gasket.
Wow.
Apparently, GM was well aware of the issues. Wow.
Wow.
Wow, that's weird. Our first two were about cars. Let's see. Momo says, I regret. This is not the game, Momo. Momo said, I regret not buying something. Condoms. These damn babies just keep popping out.
Momo.
Momo.
I love him so much.
This week, you go stand in the corner.
I love him so much.
You go, stand in the corner.
That's why you my friend.
Go stand in the corner and eat a chitlin hoagie sandwich. No, that's not a punishment. That's not punishment.
No, I'm like, make that a devil.
Yeah. Georgia Baker said, second set of Invisaligns. Oh, wow.
Oh, what happened to the second? I'm like, the first set, and you went back for more?
Wow, those things are not cheap.
And why would... What? I have so many questions, Georgia.
You're right. What happened? Like,
okay, I didn't know that's how it worked.
Tina Greenwood, super fan, said, our two Lazy Boy rocker recliners, when they arrived, finally, they weren't the correct color. They're supposed to be gray, and they are really a blue-gray color. Sounds like they did you a favor. But hubby didn't want the hassle of dealing with the shitty company, so I got stuck with them. One died, one to go. It's almost dead, so I'm glad to be getting new stuff soon. Okay, Tina.
Girl, just stab the couches and get new ones.
Mindy from the Jason and Mindy podcast says, Sunrun solar panels. Yeah, I've heard Mindy talk about these several times. Sunrun solar panels. Long story, but the moral of it is to buy solar panels outright. Worst company ever.
Oh, wow.
Sorry you had that experience, Mindy. Makila Harris said, timeshare. Oh, I remember everybody was getting stuck with those. I got some friends that got stuck with the timeshare. Oh, I'm glad I never fell into that trap.
They almost got me.
Pip Lilly said, my first pack of cigarettes.
Oh, Pip, that's a good one.
Yeah.
Oh.
Wow.
Yep.
I feel you, bro.
Yep.
Chad Samuel Jr. said, Ford Explorer, what a piece of shit that was.
Mm-hmm.
Wow, really? Okay, so we bring it into the studio. Didi, what about you? What is your most regretted purchase?
I regret purchasing my belly ring piercing.
Really?
I do.
I didn't even know you had your belly because you don't wear
it. I don't have it anymore.
Oh, okay. Yeah, you don't. And none of your pictures have it. You got infected.
Let me tell you real quick. I used to work at the post office. I used to have to throw mail.
Mm-hmm.
When I first got my belly button ring, I was throwing mail and it got snagged.
Oh, and you ripped it out?
And I ripped it. It ripped completely out.
Ouch.
But it ripped out enough and I have the scar to prove it.
Ooh, ouch.
Yeah.
Ouch.
And then from there, it never healed.
So now you got a Audi instead of an Innie?
No, now I just got what happened right there.
Is that like, baby, is that a stab wound?
Yeah, I just got a what happened to you right there. Yeah. I mean, like,
baby, did you get shot?
And my neighbor been trying to get me to get my stomach pierced again, and she don't know like the trauma I went through the first time.
Oh, my like, God. I understand why you regret that one.
Yeah, that was my regrettable purchase.
Yeah.
What about you?
Well, I have one that was all set until last week, and I have something to top it. But some people might kind of say it's kind of on the line, but I consider it a purchase. They both have something to do with
a sex robot.
No. Go sit down.
Okay.
Go stand in the corner with Momo
and
Tina.
That's why
and Tina from last week.
I love both of them. That's so crazy. Okay.
Okay. So originally, my biggest regret was having my lawn taken out and putting the rocks in.
Oh,
that was my biggest regret. Regretting a regretful purchase or whatever up until. I got my house tinted. That's now my biggest regret, having my house tinted for the termites.
Oh, my client just had her house tinted. And I was like, oh, take all your valuables. Oh, my the host from the show just got his house tinted and it was burglarized. And she was like, oh, no, they come to check our house every 30 minutes around the clock. I was like, damn, did Dino not pay for the security feature?
No, they don't offer security. Where is this house that she's getting? Somebody's coming around every 30. Is it a gated community?
No. No, where? It's a house just like this. Like, but she has a gate, but I don't think that matters.
What part of town is it in?
Oh, by my house.
So Hollywood?
Yeah, like.
And East she said Hollywood. They who? The
company that she used, I guess.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Every 30 minutes?
Every 30 minutes.
That's a lot.
That's what I was like, okay, girl.
That's a lot.
I was like, okay. Yeah. But shout out my client and shout out Gallagher. They listen, they tune into the show. But I warned her, I told her. Yeah. And I was like, wow, that's
yeah,
great.
She's straight then, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. But yeah, so I seen her house and it was fine. It wasn't burglarized, but.
Yeah, I guess not. Somebody's circling every 30 minutes. I guess not.
I didn't even know they did stuff like that.
So, yeah.
But yeah, that tent.
Okay, Dee Dee, so what's our question for next week?
This question for next week is brought to you by our brother in crime, Mr. Pip Lily, who's not here today. I'm tongue-tied, and I think I'm still slightly drunk from Marilyn's birthday last night. Anyway, the question for next week is, what musical icon do you think is highly overrated?
Oh, yeah, that's a great one.
Yeah, I really like that one.
Okay, what musical icon do you feel is highly overrated?
Yeah.
That is the question for next. Just one, people. One.
Mm-hmm.
What one musical icon?
I love that we always got to be like, oh, quick, yeah. Rules.
Because motherfuckers don't speak English. And they think unless you say one, it doesn't mean one.
Right.
No, unless I say two or more, it means one.
Yeah.
Like, learn English, damn it.
Yeah. And make it real. Don't
but not for
like,
real. I mean, it's fake outrage. I mean, you know, it's not real outrage.
I was outraged.
We
had to delete like 2 weeks in a row. We had to delete the questions.
Yeah, it's problematic, but we have a very active, you know, feed. And
we
that,
do.
For
we
that,
do.
I'm grateful because a lot of shows and people or whatever, they don't have any interaction.
No, we don't. But so, we do. We have great people that come in from CastBox. We like Muhammad. Shout out. In the feed chatting with us, and we have great fans.
Yeah, we do. Really, we do. Shout out Tina.
Shout out Momo.
Shout out BTG.
Oh, speaking of BTG.
Speaking of BTG, let's go ahead and get in with our mail. So you guys who've been following us for a while know BTG is one of our hardcore, and who is also he's one of our hardcore fans and also a what do you call it? I was gonna say like a coworker, but not a coworker. But he's also a podcaster,
a showmate, I guess.
I was trying to think of like
me too. Yeah, that's why I was like showmate was what I
yeah.
What I got
but first. He's a podcaster as well.
He's definitely a shithead.
A very very good podcaster who, by the way, just cracked 100 episodes. So shout out to him
for that.
Again, even though we did give him props, but it's been a while since he's hollered at us. So he hollered at us and he had a lot to say since he hadn't checked in a long
yeah, he's been busy
a long time. And to try to rectify his lengthy message, I did a little bit of editing, so that's what you're about to hear right now. So here we go.
Shiznit Show. It's your boy BTG, Dino Red, Pip Lily, Dijon, Monique. Pip Lily is my guy. Dijon, Monique, how you doing? Dino is my guy. How y'all doing? I haven't talked to y'all in a long time. I blame y'all. So I'm going to get to this week's question of the week, but I just wanted to say I know I'm late on the Halloween thing, but I'm on both sides of the fence. Like, I'm that person that don't really like to mess with history like that, you know what I'm saying, when it comes to certain things, especially when it comes to sports. But it does make sense to have, like, a Halloween on, like, a, you know, going towards the weekend. Like, Halloween on, what about this? Halloween on a Friday, half day for everybody. Half day for the schools. No, matter of fact, it's half day for the adults. And so they can come home, get prepared for their kids and things like that, because kids are going to get out of school in the middle of the day anyway. I mean, they're going to get out around 2 or 3, no later than that, most of them. And then, again, like a half day and the last Friday of the month. I mean, we already know if they move it to a Saturday, that's more for the adults to get shit-faced. And again, I understand for the people that, you know, that work on the weekend. Well, sorry for you, nigga. What do you want me to say? I mean, call off ahead of time. If they don't change it, that's fine with me. I do think it's pretty stupid to have Halloween, you know, on Monday through Thursday.